There has been no experience like it. I have learned more in this 10 days than I have in a whole school year. If you want to push yourself in a way that you've never been pushed, then I see no reason why you wouldn't want to come here.
The ingredients that we bring together for the summer school are great teachers, really impressive, inspiring academics. And then we bring the students to a fantastic part of France in the Normandy countryside. But the secret ingredient is that the students we select for this course are the best and brightest students we can find anywhere in the world. That's where our results come from.
It's really friendly, but also it's really challenging. Like, it challenges your preconceptions and beliefs.
They certainly teach you how to break down arguments, figure out faults in our own arguments, rather than standing by a belief and refusing to consider other views.
You know, looking practice, communism doesn't work. But it's sufficient.
That's not something that Singh is advocating. He's advocating you getting your checkbook out.
And the idea, in a way, is just to get the students up to the kind of point where they look at a text, they think, what's that about? Where's the argument going? Is it plausible? What alternatives are there to that kind of argument?
So did Locke think that the law was superior to religion?
Basically, he assumes that any religion that is worth practicing can be practiced within the bounds of anything that's worth having as law.
These are probably the best students that I've ever had the privilege to teach, not only because they are extremely bright, but most importantly because they're really passionate about ideas.
Let's get back to ethical subjectivism.
Doesn't ethical subjectivism, Susan, isn't that, surely should that be a branch of non-cognitivism?
The students are very motivated and they are also very willing to learn, not only in the classrooms, but also outside. You have like a very high quality of discussion.
There's several different types of people here, not just in terms of race or where people come from, but in terms of diversity of thought, diversity of opinion.
The social life, quite a lot of it does kind of revolve around what we've learned and like discussing it, just because we're passionate about it.
It's merging different ideas that we've learned, you know, like including game theory and politics, and mixing them together and developing our own ideas.
Debating is the key, even at breakfast, dinner, in the pool even.
In terms of the scope of subjects, we do philosophy and politics and economics and history and some related subjects.
And the small seminars are great because you can really speak up if you're afraid of talking in large groups. You're with only maybe 10 people and you get to know them really well, so you're really comfortable asking anything.
All of these speakers are kind of world famous, the experts in their field.
Every lecturer is ready to answer to all of our questions in a very analytical and organized way.
I want people to go away not necessarily convinced that what I'm saying is correct, but rather just making you think that maybe there's more than one way of thinking about certain questions.
The common impression you get is that this is something which is quite literally all over my Christmas. Actually, it takes William 6 years of serious, intense fighting before he is actually King of England.
It really helps some of our students with their university application, because we do some mock interviews, we help with the TSA.
If you fall into a trap, we want to see that you notice that, and we want to see if you can go back and like look at the assumptions you made and sort of figure out which one of them needs to be revised.
Before you go into that interview, you want to be mentally alert. You want to be awake. Move your body. Dance.
This is a program aimed at students and helping them to find their way through their university studies and beyond. So it's not just, we're going to teach you something. Here it is. It's about helping people to plan out successful career paths that are both intellectual and professional.
You know, I had 10 days of a lot of fun. I think that I'm sort of a more interesting person, but also there's a lot more than I'm interested in.
I can't stress how much I've grown as a person, and for me, that's priceless.
If you put yourself in a kind of immersive experience where you keep on learning new things, that's when you find out who you kind of really are, and you find out how much more you want to know.
It's really something that I didn't expect to find here. I was expecting it to be good, but it was great, and I think that's the whole point.